We're going to do a scenic flight in Microsoft Flight Simuator 2020 from Milford Sound across to Queenstown. And we're going to use the extra 300 just because I've got a Bell 47 for Microsoft Flight Simulator, but it's quite a lot slower than the 500 I was using in the X-plane equivalent. So we'll use this one because it'll be a bit quicker, and we can compare the two sceneries. I'll try and follow the same flight path I did in the X-plane previous video. Right, let's get going. Sitting on the ground in Milford Sound. Right, we'll take off and cruise around the sound, and then we'll head back up and follow the same route we did in the Hughes 500. Good to go. A little bit rusty in this one. This one's very sensitive, but I picked it because of the speed it's got. Don't be surprised if we're upside down a couple of times during the flight. Milford Sound. Now we're coming back over the top. It's looking up towards Sutherland Falls, up around the corner at the end of that valley. Some places in the Microsoft one, the auto doesn't quite meshes nicely onto the terrain, meshes, it doesn't explain, but overall I think it's better because the trees and the amount of 3D scenery and the atmospherics is next level with the weather system. Something's rattling in here and I don't know what it is. So we'll be following the main road from Milford back through to Tiarnell some of the way past the tunnel, and then we'll cut across like we did with the Hughes 500. You can see the ortho's a little bit warped on the side of those hills, just because I think the way the angle the photo was taken using the Bing images is not quite aligning to the shape of the terrain. If you want to have a really good look at the roads just up in front of us where it starts to wind, I'll just give you a bit of a look at it. Get a bit of horsepower on now just to get through this pass. is the tunnel below us. There's the other side of the tunnel down there. The shadowing in this is really good. I just can't help myself when I'm in a plane like this. The road's gotta be down there somewhere. I gotta see it somehow. The road. Good view of it now. I'll do a touch and go in Glenorchy, just like we did in the 500, except this will be just on the grass. Rather aggressive. I knew the stall was going to come on then. The road heads off back down that valley out behind us there. So we'll drop into this next valley that leads us down to Lake Wakatipu. Spectacular scenery. we're probably doing a good 30, 40 knots quicker than the Hughes 500 in the X-plane, just because it's, got tapped out. I think I can't resist. Once we get over this ridge where we approach down into Glenorchy, I'll have a go at a Lomshavak. Beautiful lake. There's Mount Alfred and Paradise Valleys, and Town of Paradise is just in behind that. Right, we'll have a go to Lomshavak while we're out over this. Plenty of height off the lake. Just bring her back to 140 knots. Okay. Increase power a bit there, 140. Okay, start pitching, rolling, and yawing. Fly out the top. Let's go straight into a right base for a touch and go on Glenorchy. Get out of here straight away again. Start climbing out here somewhere, I think, like we did in the 500. If you're noticing any sort of stutter or lag, it's probably because I'm running the recording software in the background. Normally it's pretty smooth, good frame rates. The sunlight on the ground is just amazing in this one. Just hang on the straps here for a bit. Rugged country. I think overall this is still probably the best looking for a flight simulator I've seen yet. And there's the little saddle I ducked up through in the 500 in the X-plane version. I think I like this one, definitely looks better. Go through here, around to the left, and go up past Queenstown itself, and then we'll have a bit of a quick look at the shot over before we get back and land. Just can't help myself with the upside down stuff. Queenstown. Skyline and Luge and the gondolas over there. We might actually duck out through this valley and go look at the shot over. we'll blast up through the canyon here, and then we'll stall, turn back, and come back down the back into land. Yeah, once the terrain gets a bit steep like that, the river sort of sometimes hits up the sides a little bit. Come back around. Yeah, that bit down there is a little bit off center to the bottom of the valley. Apart from these little bits where it gets a little bit off center with the terrain itself, it's overall it's just spectacular. All right, time to head in for a landing at Queenstown. We're not supposed to do this, but I'm just cutting across the grass. Try and miss all these lights that are everywhere. just cut across there, I think. I'll just park around the back here somewhere. I think this is close enough. I think it's about roughly where we parked last time. There we go.